Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilmanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on internal combustion engine. This is lecture number 6, fuel supply system in SI engine. We recap from the previous lectures. So in the earlier lectures, we discussed about the working principle of IC engines. All types of IC engine, 4-stroke cycle petrol engine, 4-stroke cycle diesel engine, and 2-stroke cycle engine. And we compared the petrol engine and diesel engine, and we compared the 4-stroke cycle engine and 2-stroke cycle engine. And also we studied in the earlier lecture the fuels and combustion in IC engine. So the calorific value of the fuel, the chemical combustion of the fuel, excess air calculation, the fuel requirement of IC engine. So in the case of SI engine, what are the requirement of fuel, everything we discussed in the earlier lecture. And in this lecture, so we are going to discuss about the fuel supply system in the SI engine. So how the fuel is supplied to the engine cylinder, that is what the fuel supply system. And in that, there are few topics we have: types of air fuel mixer, engine mixer requirement, working of a simple carburetor, and air fuel ratio calculation. And the learning outcome for the lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define stoichiometric mixer, rich mixer, lean mixer, and explain the working of a simple carburetor. So the fuel supply system in SI engine. So look at the diagram for a few seconds. You look at the diagram, and even if you want to note down a rough diagram of this, you can note it down. So identify the parts. So we have the carburetor where the air and the fuel are entering, and we have a throttle valve, and then we have the engine cylinder, intake manifold, combustion chamber, cylinder, inlet valve, and exhaust valve. And this is the engine cylinder. So the intake manifold is connected with the carburetor, where the atmospheric air and fuel from the fuel tanks are supplied. So the carburetor is preparing the mixture of air and the fuel, and it is regulated. The quantity of the air fuel mixture supply is regulated by the throttle valve. So the required quantity of air fuel mixture is supplied to the engine. When the engine intake valve opens, the air fuel mixture will enter into the engine cylinder, that is combustion chamber. So when the piston is descending, moving downward, the air fuel mixture is drawn into the engine cylinder using the suction stroke. So in a SI engine, the homogeneous mixture of air and the fuel is prepared outside the engine cylinder and is admitted during the intake stroke. And the process of formation of combustible fuel air mixture by mixing proper amount of fuel with the air before admission to the engine cylinder is called as carburation. And the device used for this is called as carburetor. So this is the carburetor, so which is doing the operation called carburation, which is mixing air and the fuel. So correct quantity of air and the fuel based on the engine requirement. So the engine require different kinds of different proportion, different mixer, air fuel mixer. So the preparing the air fuel mixer according to the engine requirement is the purpose, is the duty of the carburetor. So carburation is the process of mixing air and the fuel and admit into the engine cylinder, and the carburetor is the device used for the purpose. The carburation process in a spark ignition engine is influenced by engine speed, vaporization characteristics of the fuel, temperature of the incoming air, and design of the carburetor. So the engine speed, so the carburetor engine speed, when the engine speed increases, we require more amount of air and fuel, so we have to supply more amount of fuel. Vaporization characteristics, so that is volatility of the fuel. So how quickly the vapor, the fuel is getting evaporated at the operating condition, and temperature of the incoming air, which is influencing the vaporization characteristics. So these two are interconnected: vaporization characteristics of the fuel and temperature of incoming air. When you have higher temperature of incoming air, that will easily promote the vaporization of fuel. And design of the carburetor, so how the carburetor is designed for better mixing of air and the fuel, that is also very important parameter. types of air fuel mixer. So we have three different types of air fuel mixer. The engine is generally operated different loads and speed. So the for this proper air fuel mixer should be supplied to the engine cylinder. The fuel and the air are mixed to form three different types of mixer: chemically correct mixer, rich mixer, and lean mixer. So the engine is generally operated at a different load and the speed. So how to recognize, how to understand different load and the speed? So even you are working with your two wheeler, you are riding your two wheeler, at a certain time we are giving more throttle and the engine speed will be very high. At certain time in the when we have a more traffic, you are reducing the speed. So the speed, when this I mean the speed, varying speed, we are operating the vehicle at varying speed. And sometimes we are going single person, so the load is very less. When you have more number of people in the vehicle, the load, engine load is increasing. So the different load and the different speed conditions, the engine is operating at a different load and the different speed, the engine requires different types of air fuel mixer. So there are three types of air fuel mixer: chemically correct, rich mixer, and lean mixer. We will define one by one. So the chemically correct or stoichiometric mixer is one in which there is just enough air for complete combustion of the fuel. That is what we defined earlier. Chemically correct mixer, we have calculated it is 15:1 for petrol. So complete combustion means that all carbon and hydrogen in the fuel converted into CO2 and H2O respectively. So for gasoline fuel, C8H18, the chemically correct air fuel ratio is 15:1. So that means air fuel, 15 quantity of air, 15 kg of air for 1 kg of fuel. That is what 15:1. Chemically correct air fuel ratio. Rich mixer, a mixer which contains less air than the stoichiometric requirement is called as rich mixer. So less air means more amount of fuel. Say for example, less than 15:1, 10:1, 12:1, they are called as a rich mixer. And lean mixer, the mixer which contains more amount of air than the stoichiometric requirement is called as lean mixer. For example, 17:1, 19:1. So the amount of air is higher in the case of lean mixer. In the rich mixer, the amount of air is less than the chemically correct requirement. And look at here. So this is the combustible range in the case of a petrol engine. So 9:1 to 19:1. So 15:1 is the chemically correct mixer. So we can go up to 9:1. Rich mixer, we can go up to 9:1. And lean mixer, we can go up to 19:1. So when you have mixer, when you have the air fuel mixer beyond 19:1, it is too lean to burn. So we cannot burn and produce power. When you have very rich, so for example, when you have very more amount of fuel, that leads to incomplete combustion. It is not possible to burn. So it is rich, very rich mixer. So there will be more loss of power. So this is called as excess fuel and excess air. So 15:1 is the chemically correct air fuel ratio. We can operate the petrol engine between 9:1 to 19:1. So 9:1 is a rich mixer and 19:1 is the lean, very lean mixer. So that is what the air fuel ratio. The air fuel mixer outside the range either too rich or too lean to burn and sustain the flame. The carburetor should provide an air fuel ratio according to the engine operating requirement, and this ratio must be within the combustible range. So the carburetor should produce between 9:1 to 19:1. So that is what the combustible range for the petrol engine. And you look at this diagram. The air fuel ratio in the x-axis, power output in the y-axis in kilowatts, and the brake specific fuel consumption. So we define this parameter, brake specific fuel consumption, that is amount of fuel consumed per kilowatt of power generation, kilogram per kilowatt hour, amount of fuel consumed per kilowatt of power produced, that is what the specific fuel consumption. And for power output, you look at the curve. So we are starting from 10:1. So the power output is increasing, and here it is maximum, 12:1, it is maximum, then it decreases. So when you, how to read the, what is the understanding of the curve? So when the air fuel ratio is 10:1, the power output in kilowatt is slightly lower. So we assume when the air fuel ratio increases, say for example 12:1, the power output is maximum. When you increase more, so the amount of power produced is less. So the best power, is 12:1. So 12:1, it is a rich mixer. So because 15:1 is the stoichiometric mixer. So 15:1 is the stoichiometric mixer. There is chemically correct mixer. Now it is less quantity of air, that is rich mixer. For rich, when you have rich mixer 12:1, the power produced by the engine is maximum. And you take the brake fuel, brake specific fuel consumption. So for 10:1, once again the BSFC is here. When you increase the air fuel ratio, the BSFC is decreasing and it takes a minimum value, then it increases. So the brake specific fuel consumption for any engine, it should be low. It should be low. So for 16:1, it is the lowest value, that is best economy value. So 16:1, you listen, this is lean mixer. So the 15:1 is the chemically correct. So we have excess air. So this is lean mixer. So for best economy, we have the lean mixer. We require the lean mixer. For the best power, we require the rich mixer. So how to understand when you ride the vehicle at a designed speed, for example 60 kilometers per hour speed on standard road condition, it is called as best economy. That means the amount of fuel consumed will be the minimum required amount of fuel will be consumed. It will be economical operation. So when you throttle more and you ride the vehicle with a higher speed or a higher load, it will consume more power. It will be operated in the rich condition. When you produce more power, you require rich condition. When you want to operate economically, and we are going with the lean mixer. This is what the engine air fuel ratio requirement for the best power and best specific fuel consumption. It may be noted that the best power mixer is much higher than the chemically correct mixer, and the best economy mixer is slightly leaner than the chemically correct mixer. So for best power, we require richer mixer. For best economy, we require leaner mixer. So it is desirable to run the engine on the maximum economy mixer under normal operating conditions, and for quick acceleration and for maximum power, rich mixer is required. So it is the requirement is changing depending on the operating condition of the engine. The carburetor of the engine is to supply air fuel mixer to satisfy the demand of the engine. The three general range of throttle operation of the carburetor are idling range, cruising range and the high power range. So idling range means we require rich mixer, cruising range means we require lean mixer, and high power range means you require the rich mixer. So look at the diagram. Listen to the diagram for a few minutes. So x-axis we have the throttle opening 0%, 50% opening, 100% opening, and y-axis we have the lean mixer on the bottom, rich mixer at the top. We have the best power horizontal line xx dash and best economy zz dash, and the continuous line is for the single cylinder engine and dotted line for the multi cylinder engine. And we have three ranges: idling range, cruising range and the power range. And we discuss about the single cylinder engine. So look at the single cylinder engine, the line for the single cylinder engine A, B, C, D. So in the idling condition, so for example you are starting the engine from the zero speed, you are just kick start the engine and the engine is running. So this is what the engine is running, but the vehicle is not moving. So we slowly increasing throttle, and that is what called as idling condition from the start of the engine. So throttle, what do you to do with the throttling? Accelerator, you are slowly opening. So in the idling range, so initially we have the rich mixer. So we have the rich mixer. When you throttle, when you open more throttling, when you open the throttling valve more, the air fuel ratio decreases and we are coming to the best economy condition. So when you operate at the best economy condition, so we require the throttle opening somewhere between 30 to 75%. So 30 to 75%, that is what called as best economy operation. So when you operate with this condition, throttle opening, the amount of fuel consumed will be less. So normally in the normal operating condition, we have to work with the best economy condition. When you want to increase the speed, when you want to more power, then you give more throttling, more than 70% or 75%. So the again the air filled mixer, it becomes rich mixer. So cruising idling range. So we start with the when you start the engine, you start with the rich mixer, and when you operate, when you slowly increase the speed, and we come to the best economy air filled ratio. That is, we operate with roughly more than 30% throttle opening and less than 70% throttle opening. So with this condition, you will get the best economy operation. When you open the throttle more, so the power amount of fuel supplied will be more, and there will be more power produced. That is called as power range. So for cruising range operation, we require lean mixer, so best economy operation, and for power range, we require rich mixer or more amount of fuel into the engine cylinder. So this diagram you have to understand so that you can clearly visualize the load amount of air fuel requirement depending on the engine speed and the engine power. And this is the simple carburetor. So actually nowadays we are using advanced carburetor that will study later. The different type of real automobile carburetor will study later. Now we'll do with a simple carburetor. So look at the diagram. For a few seconds you take your diagram, observe the diagram, and identify the various parts available in the diagram. We have a duct pipeline, so through the which the air is entering here and flows through the pipeline. The air filled mixture is leaving on the other side. This is called as throttle valve. And we have the adjustment for idling. So idling, suppose you want to increase the amount of fuel, you have to adjust the screw. And here we have the choke valve. So choke valve, sometimes in the moped, what we do when the engine is not starting, we close the choke valve and we kick start it, so it will open. So what is the purpose of choking? When you close the choke valve, the amount of air supply will be less and there will be more fuel in the air fuel mixer. That is what the purpose of choking, closing the choke valve. And in the pipeline, so pipeline is not of same cross section. So here there is a venturi. So this portion is called as venturi. The cross sectional area is decreasing and then increasing. That is called as venturi. And in the venturi we have a pipeline. So the pipeline, tip of the pipeline, the level of tip of the pipeline is less than the level of the fuel in the float chamber. So look at here. This is the level of the fuel in the float chamber, and the tip of the pipe, tip of the small pipe is more. So it is slightly high. This height is called as Z. Is small Z is the height level difference between the tip of the fuel metering orifice and then the fuel in the float chamber. So this is the float chamber where you have a float. And the float chamber is vent to the atmosphere, and in the float chamber we have a fuel supply valve and the float pivot, and you have a small pivot here, small needle here. The needle will close the fuel supply valve, and here we have the strainer. That is the strainer will remove the impurities from the fuel, and fuel is from the fuel tank is connected here. So fuel from the fuel tank enters to the float chamber through the strainer and through the fuel supply valve. So here the valve is closed by the float. We have a small valve which is closing this opening. Now we just explain the operation. So the float will be closing the small fuel supply valve. When the fuel level decreases in the float chamber, the float level will go down and this valve will open. So when the float is going down, the valve will open and the fuel will enter into the float chamber. As the fuel is entering into the float chamber, the float will raise and it will close. So a constant level of fuel is maintained in the float chamber using the float. And here the way it is went to the atmosphere, because above the fuel surface the atmosphere pressure is acting, so that gives the pressure head for pushing the fuel. And the fuel level here, so it is actually in the fuel metering orifice, the fuel level will be the level of the fuel here. So here there is a small gap. Now this is the for fuel line. Now the air is entering here. So air is from the atmosphere entering into the pipeline. And in the venturi, when the air comes to the venturi, because of the change in the cross section, the pressure decreases and the velocity increases. So here the pressure will be very very low at the center, right? The where you have the fuel metering orifice, you have the fuel metering orifice. So fuel discharge nozzle. So this is fuel discharge nozzle. So here the pressure will be very less. So here we are operating with here the pressure, fuel pressure acting here is atmospheric pressure. So here the pressure will be less than the atmospheric pressure. So because of the pressure difference, so the fuel from the fuel discharge nozzle will come to the will escape here and mix with the air, and the air fuel mixture will go to the engine. So the fuel discharge nozzle and fuel metering orifice. So the fuel metering orifice will regulate the quantity of the fuel, will supply, regulate, actually it will govern the quantity of fuel supply. And here because of the pressure difference between the atmospheric pressure and the here almost it is vacuum pressure. Vacuum pressure is created. So using the pressure difference, the fuel will come out of the nozzle and it is mixed with the air, and the air fuel mixture will go to the engine cylinder through the throttle valve. So by changing the position of the throttle valve, we will supply more amount of air fuel mixture to the engine cylinder. So this is simple carburetor. So you draw the diagram, you mention the part, and you take a few seconds of time and write down in simple sentences about the construction and working of a simple carburetor. And how to calculate the air fuel ratio? So mass of air plus divided by mass of fuel equal to CDA divided by CDF into A2 by AF into square root of rho A by rho F. So MA is the mass flow rate of air, MF is the mass flow rate of fuel, A2 is the cross sectional area of the venturi throat, AF is the cross sectional area of the fuel nozzle, rho A is the density of the air, rho F is the density of the fuel, CDA is the coefficient of discharge of venturi, and CDF is the coefficient of discharge of the fuel nozzle. So everything we have to substitute and calculate the mass of air divided by mass of fuel, that is air fuel ratio for the petrol engine. And we stop here. So we have some questions to answer based on the lecture what we observed for the past 20 minutes. The relative air fuel, relative fuel air ratio for maximum power in a spark ignition engine is 0.8, 0.6, 1.2 and 1.5. Relative fuel air ratio is equivalence ratio. So the equivalence ratio for the petrol engine, the answer is 1.2. Equivalence ratio for petrol engine for maximum power is 1.2. At starting in the petrol engine, we supply weak fuel air ratio is required, rich fuel air ratio is needed, chemically correct fuel air ratio is needed, any fuel air ratio will do at starting. Yes, the answer is rich fuel air ratio is needed at the start of the petrol engine, that is idling range. Carburetor used for gas turbine, spark ignition engine, compression ignition engine, and none of the above. So we select spark ignition engine or petrol engine. And these are all the reference books I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it. And other ICE engine books also we can refer for better information, more information on the topic. And thank you for watching. You can please post your comments on the comment box of the YouTube video. Subscribe the channel. I have published more than 160 video lectures on thermal engineering subject, engineering thermodynamics, thermal engineering, hidden mass transfer. I have uploaded the solution of the gate question paper also. It will be useful for your better learning. And you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number. So I will sincerely answer all your queries. Thank you for watching, and we will meet again.